Well, I'm already assuming that you have watched our video on the RC200. So we already know how it handles on the go-kart track. We already know all the changes and all the bits that are new here and there. And we also know that it costs a whopping 2.2 lakh rupees for a 200cc, almost 25 bhp bike. So we at the Drivers Hub had an oddball question as to, would we really spend 2.2 lakh rupees on a 200cc motorcycle, or we would look at something that's a lot more powerful, a lot more faster, and also, you know, something a lot more refined and exotic for almost the same or less money. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Kiran, welcome to the Drivers Hub, and today we are here to find out, is paying 2.2 lakh rupees really sensible for the RC200, or is it more sensible to spend the same amount of money or even less for something that's available in the used market? Let's find out. Well, after the update, the RC200 really looks more appealing. Well, apart from the headlight side, because again, that's a little bit of a gray area, but the lines are nice and clear. It looks like it's ready to cut the air through, and it looks like it's a very, very fast bike even while standing still. And also, you can see the rear is completely new. There is a different sub-trellis frame. The seats are brand new. They are more spacious. They are more comfortable. And also, it has a bigger tank. But how big is this tank compared to our competitor? Well, that's a question we'll answer very soon. Apart from that, the handlebars are also a little bit up, so it's again a lot more comfortable than the previous generation of RC, but it still has that aggression feel to it. And again, if you really want that serious aggression, you can lower the clip-ons and then be ready to hit your B roads or the track. And the wheels, they are almost lighter than the previous generation RCs by 0.5 kgs on both the ends. So again, all that unsprung mass has made the rideability really different from the older RC. Well, the Ninja 300 is one of the few options that's available in the used bike market, which is, well, almost if not cheaper than a brand new RC200, and also more powerful. It is a parallel twin, it's more refined, it's also having almost double the power of the RC200. So, well, we are here to find out if really this is what you should pick over a brand new RC200. The lines and the designs is timeless. It's been almost a decade old, and well, when you look at the ideal sports bike silhouette, this bike has it. That is why people still buy it, and they still look for it in the market even now. Used Ninja 300s are in the market well below the 2 lakh rupee range, with very early models being found at 1.3 to 1.5 lakh rupees. But the Ninja and RC technically do serve two very different purposes. The Ninja is more of a sports tourer, whereas the RC feels like a proper balls-to-the-wall sports bike, even if they have softened it a little bit with this new update. The Ninja definitely isn't as aggressive as the RC, but that doesn't mean that the Kawi can't hold its own in the corners. The Kawasaki is a heavier bike out of the two, and I'm not gonna lie, you can feel the extra 5 to 6 kgs, but there's a certain fluidity in the chassis, and the way it feels when you're scraping your knee guards feels very natural. The bike just holds onto its line once you get onto it. On the other hand, the RC200 feels super nimble and super light on its feet. It feels like Canelo Alvarez dodging punches left and right and then suddenly countering with a punch. That's how amazing the RC200 feels. It feels sharp, agile, and the 200cc single cylinder means that during the corner exit, you don't have to worry about losing control. Moreover, this engine packs quite a hefty punch of almost 25 PS, but the Ninja absolutely crushes it with 39 horsepower, but not so glorious 300cc engine note. If you're getting a Ninja 300, please get a proper performance exhaust to let that parallel twin sing. During our ride over to the shoot location, the RC200 felt much more composed and comfortable in the tight city traffic.
The previous RC would have burnt your leg to crisp in standing traffic and would have absolutely broken your back if you rode it for more than 30 seconds. But the new RC, with its comfortable seats, easier riding position, feels more at bay. But the Ninja 300 feels like it was meant for long distance sports touring. Don't get me wrong though, it isn't a proper sports tourer like the GS or the Versus, but it definitely can take the beating like one. The Tokyo engine means you have to downshift less to make an overtake. Overall, when it comes to medium distance rides, the Ninja is an absolute weapon. So now the question comes, which would you choose? Well, you have to consider the main talking point of both bikes. And no, it's not related to the engine, looks or power. It is related to you and your preferences. The Ninja 300 is a used motorcycle, which means it comes with its own difficulties. Anything used isn't going to be in perfect condition, so you should have an open mindset of spending at least 15 to 20k on getting the bike back into its optimal shape. Also remember, the Ninja 300 is a Kawi at the end of the day, so the after sales and parts are on the expensive, but since it's Japanese, the chances of anything failing are quite low and the build quality is a level apart. The KTM on the other hand will be a brand spanking new bike if you buy it. You will get stuff like warranty, free services and very vast KTM Bajaj after sales services, which ensure you won't have any issues in getting the bike repaired. And again, the KTM has the latest kit on it and also has new digital screen, which is a good modern touch compared to the Ninja's analog tech, which is over a decade old. All these things should be taken into consideration while making your purchase. Whereas for me personally, I would choose the RC because, well, it's light, nimble and up to date, and the new update really makes the bike very easy and friendly to ride very fast.
Take it. And Senna sprints away.